Hi, it's James from CDNify here. In this video, I'm going to show you how you can drastically increase the speed of your WordPress blog using CDNify. Now, I've got a WordPress blog here. As you can see, there's not much content on this blog. The thing I want to point out very quickly, one common misconception is that there's a lot of effort involved if you've got backlogs of content on your WordPress blog. So let's say your blog is 5 years old. You don't want to have to go through 5 years worth of content updating all of your links and updating all of the images and pointing them onto a CDN. Well, the great thing about this is you don't have to do any work. You just set a couple of configuration options in the plugin I'm just about to show you, and it does the hard work for you. So let's just quickly take a look at the problem. As you can see here, I've got a couple of images embedded into my post. This one, for example, well, it's got a small thumbnail version, but if I click it and look at the full size version, as you can see, this image is very, very high resolution. This is our team here at CDNify, and loading was pretty quick then because I've just opened this image and it's already cached on my browser. But generally speaking, this is a huge image and it will take a very long time to load. Also will cause a lot of strain on your web server and use a lot of your bandwidth. So if we offload all of the heavy assets like images and CSS and JavaScript files onto a CDN, it will speed everything up and it will also reduce your bandwidth bill for your web hosting account and will reduce your server load. If you're experiencing a lot of traffic on your blog and the server is slowing down, this is a fantastic way of optimizing everything. So we log into our WordPress control panel and we're going to go to plugins and choose add new. The plugin we need is something called W3 Total Cache. If we click search and then install this plugin, it's free of course, and we'll set that up on our WordPress installation here. It takes a couple of seconds to complete. Then we could go ahead and activate the plugin. Now this is really, really straightforward to get started with. This plugin is very, very comprehensive and offers a lot more functionality than just integrating a CDN, but that's what we're concerning ourselves with today. So if we head on over to, you'll see a new menu item called Performance comes up and click on General Settings, and we scroll down until we find the CDN configuration, which is just here. First thing we need to do is enable it, and the second thing we need to do is select our CDN type. In this case, we choose generic mirror. We then click on save all changes. Now you'll see there's a red alert box which comes up saying a configuration issue prevents CDN from working. That's because we haven't configured our hostname. Now I've already set up a CDN resource called cdn.demo123.org, and that points towards this CDN. And this has been set to pull the content from our top level domain demo123.org. So if we then go ahead and we can either copy the hostname if we've set that up on our DNS, or if not, we can just copy the CNAME record, in which case we'll paste this in onto our control panel. Head back on to the total cache configuration. We can either click this link here, or we can actually scroll down here and choose a CDN option. Now we'll open the website back up just so you can see what happens. And as you can see, our content is just currently loaded from our web server, demo123.org. Obviously everything is pulled out the WP content folder. But if we enable the CDN, just by scrolling down, choose configuration and replace site's hostname with, this is where we need to input our CDN hostname, which can either be the long form URL that's provided, or it could be cdn.demo123.org if I've set that up on my DNS settings. Very important that you set that up first, otherwise it won't work. Once we've done that, we can then click test mirror. This will run a quick test to make sure that it's working and configured. If you've only just created this CDN hostname, it can take up to 10 minutes, it's important to note. So if the test fails for any reason, leave it for 10 minutes and try again. Once we've done that, if we click save all settings, this will then update our entire WordPress blog so it starts using the CDN on all the images, on the CSS, on the JavaScript, really, really powerful. So if we then refresh this, as you can see, our links are currently pointing at demo123.org, but if we refresh this site, you may need to do a hard refresh, you'll see now the reference at the bottom points to the CDN. So this image, instead of being loaded from our local server, is actually now loading from the CDN, which is absolutely fantastic. So this will drastically increase your site performance, speed everything up for your visitors, and you don't have to do any hard work. It's really, really straightforward to get set up. The other thing to point out, if we look at our page source, is things like the CSS files are now automatically loaded from the CDN as well. So this really is a comprehensive solution. It doesn't just speed up the actual content of your posts, e.g. images or flash files. It also links all of your images, all of your CSS and JavaScript and things like that. So they're also loaded from the CDN. That's how you integrate our CDNify service onto your WordPress installation. Thanks very much for watching. If you haven't got a CDNify account, you can go and create one for free to start trying us today at www.cdnify.com. If you have any questions or need any support with getting set up, feel free to contact our support team. Our guys are great and they're ready to help you out and answer any questions you may have. Thanks very much for watching.